Continuing on with the basics of algebra, we're going to look at the rules for addition and subtraction of algebraic expressions. Now, the key idea here is that you're going to collect like terms. That's how you simplify addition and subtraction. So remember, you have to pay attention to the combination of variables in each term. They have to be exactly the same. They have to contain the exact same letters with the exact same powers. What's allowed to be different on each term is the coefficient, so you don't need to pay attention to the number or the sign that it may have. So when we look at these four terms here, ab squared, ab cubed, ab squared, a cubed b, there's only one set of like terms here, and that's the ab squared. So when we add these together, this is when we pay attention to the coefficients. The first one has no coefficient, so you can assume that's a 1. The second one has a coefficient of positive 6. So when you have 1 plus 6, you get 7, and that's how you simplify. So here's another example, and I'm not going to look at the coefficients as we go. We've got an x squared y, x squared y squared, x squared y squared, x squared y. So going through those terms, I can see that there's a pair of x squareds. One has a coefficient of 1, one has a coefficient of minus 3. And there's a pair of x squared y terms. One has a coefficient of 4, and the other has a coefficient of minus 5. I'll also note that the order of the variables could have been different. For example, if I have an x squared y term, and then a y x squared term, those are still like terms, because the order of multiplication can be rearranged. Let's look at mn squared t cubed, m squared n t cubed, mn squared t cubed, mn cubed t squared, and n squared t cubed. Now there's one set of like terms there, mn squared t cubed, and the others are all different combinations of variables. For this example, let's do more than just identify the like terms. Let's actually follow it through and simplify. So the first thing we want to do is figure out which terms are like terms. So we've got an xy term, an x squared term, another xy term, a y term, another x squared term, and another y term. Remember, you don't have to pay attention to the coefficients at this point. But we do have three matching pairs. There's xy pairs, x squared pairs, and y pairs. So now at this point, you can simplify right away, but it might help just to rewrite it in a different order. So we'll put all of our like terms together. So we have minus xy plus 10xy, then plus 2x squared minus x squared minus y plus 3y. Writing things out this way just makes things a little more clear, and it might keep you from making a silly mistake. And this is where the coefficients become very important, because now we can simplify each of these groupings based on the coefficients. For example, with the minus xy, that becomes a minus 1 plus 10 more. So overall, you have positive 9. With the x squareds, you have plus 2 and then minus 1. So that leaves you with plus 1. And then minus y plus 3y leaves you with positive 2. Some expressions that you'll see will have groupings. So remember, with order of operations, anything in brackets needs to be done first. And sometimes when you're rearranging things algebraically, you might need to remove those brackets in order to get at what's inside. So we'll look at a simple case where we have a plus sign in front of the brackets. Before we get rid of these brackets, I just want to note that even though the 4y squared in this expression doesn't have a positive, it's inferred that it is a positive 4y squared. If something is negative, you'll definitely need the negative sign, but if something is just left off, then you can assume that it's positive. Normally, if you have something out front of the brackets, you have to multiply through to each term by what's outside the brackets. But what we have outside here is just a plus 1. So if you were to multiply through with a plus 1, you get 1 times 4y squared is 4y squared, and 1 times minus 2x is still minus 2x. So nothing really changes here. And since these two things inside the brackets aren't like terms, it's not like you can condense them. So even with order of operations, you just kind of say, okay, I can't do anything, so you just remove the brackets in the next step. Now what we're gonna do is go through and look for like terms. We have an x squared, an xy, a y squared, and an x term. There's nothing here that we can collect in like terms, and so that's all we can do. Let's look at another case. Here we have ab plus, in brackets, minus a plus b. Again, we have a plus sign out front of the brackets, so that's like taking a 1 and multiplying by minus a and getting minus a again, and taking a 1 and multiplying by b and getting positive b again. Minus a and b aren't like terms, so you can't do anything inside the brackets, so these effectively get dropped. So you have ab minus a plus b. These three terms are all unlike, so we can't combine them any further than that. Let's look at a slightly different case where we still have the brackets. There's no number out front, but we do have a minus. When you have a minus out front, that's the same thing as having a negative 1. So then what you have to do is take that negative 1 and multiply it through to each of the terms. If you take minus 1 times 2x squared, that turns it into a minus 2x squared. If you take a minus 1 times y, that turns it into a minus y. Effectively, when you have a minus in front of the brackets, you go through each term and you change the sign as you remove the brackets. So this becomes 6 plus minus 1 times 2x squared plus y, but then that multiplies through and you effectively change the signs. And you get 6x minus 2x squared minus y. Let's take a look at another example. So we've got a large set of brackets here and one minus sign out front. So remember, that's like having a minus 1 out front, and then it needs to multiply into every single term as you get rid of the brackets. So when that happens, each term inside the brackets gets their sign changed from whatever it was, and then you can drop the brackets. So now you have 8x cubed plus x squared y squared minus 5x squared y plus 2xy squared minus 7y. Again, there's no like terms left here, so that's as far as you can go with this algebraic expression. Now let's look at simplifying one where we have to break some brackets and we can also get out some like terms at the end. So we've got minus 2y squared minus 7y plus 5 minus 5y squared plus 8y minus 6. So with the first set of brackets, it's assumed that it's a plus sign out front because it's left blank. And with the second set of brackets, we have a negative 1. So with the first set of brackets, we're not really going to need to change a whole lot. And with the second set of brackets, we're going to flip each of the signs. So that minus 1 will multiply through. So now we'll see that the first set of brackets gets dropped, minus 2y squared, minus 7y plus 5, and all of the terms in the second set of brackets has changed sign. So now we have minus 2y squared, minus 7y plus 5, minus 5y squared, minus 8y plus 6. So now we need to collect our like terms. You can see that we have a couple of y squared terms, we have a couple of y terms, and we have a couple of constant terms. So each one of those can be added in pairs. So overall, with the y squares, we have a minus 2 and then a minus 5 more, so that's minus 7y squared. And with the y's, we have minus 7 minus 8 more is minus 15, and plus 5 plus 6 gives you 11. So this one is now simplified.